So since I got top surgery, can I like totally flash you?
Oh, I'm such a cam boy.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Miles. There's gonna be a video all about my body very, very soon. But first, dancing montage. I was sliced open 4 weeks ago, so I can't really move much. So there is an I've called y'all here today. I wanted to make a video addressing some things because I haven't felt completely okay in front of a camera for a little while. For a while, I haven't been completely okay, and you guys know me well enough now that a lot of you guys picked up on it. Currently, I feel great. Currently, I just feel like me, and I'm ready to start making videos and to talk to you guys and just be in this world again. I did a lot of stuff last year, and not even like videos. Like all in all, I didn't make that many videos.
I'm transgender, and last year I started my transition, which takes a lot on you physically and a lot on you mentally.
I was invited to a lot of events last year as an LGBTQ plus activist. I think if I did the calculations correct, I did somewhere around 40 onstage events last year where I was on stage with a microphone for like at least an hour talking to young queer and trans kids and their supportive parents and just spreading love and positivity and sharing a lot of my journey. I was so honest to myself and to other people last year. More so than I ever had been before, and I learned so much just from opening myself. There are so many times in my coming out process where I felt completely and utterly alone. It's so easy to feel alone because you're really trapped in your bubble of like your home life, which is just your family, and then a little bit bigger bubble that you're in, which is your school, which is only how many thousand kids, if that, and then it's your town or your city that you just happen to be born into that you're kind of stuck in until you're 18, 19, and then you gotta get into college or find a job or have money to move out and go other places, and it's so easy to get in the headspace of like, wow, it will never get better.
It does.
You are not alone. If there's anything that I learned from last year, you are not alone, because I met people that are just like me hundreds and hundreds of times over. Through my entire top surgery experience, I was just talking to guys on Instagram that also got the same surgery and just looking for that support. But pretty recently, I privatized a large number of my YouTube videos and a large number of my Instagram pictures pre-transition. I've said this in live events so many times that I thought I would never take down any pre-transition videos, because I remember what it was like being that 11-year-old boy and being able to find a trans guy on the internet and be able to scroll all the way back in his pictures and his videos to find what he looked like when he looked like me at that point. And that gave me so much hope that I thought I didn't want to take that away from any other kid that could potentially do the same thing with me. I took so much from learning from the internet to help me in my life that I just want to do the same for someone else that's in the same situation. And I don't know, I didn't think I'd have to make a video about this because I didn't think people would really care, but I've gotten enough messages where I'm like, that's so nice, let me give an explanation. For me, it's very difficult to have old pictures and videos and audio of myself before my transition because a lot of personal things were out there. The way I sounded, the way I looked, what my birth name was. It was so difficult for me to have all that out there, but I didn't take them down because I was getting harassed or bullied or like anything like that. Like, I'm strong enough in myself that I am a guy. The trans part doesn't define me. Me being a guy defines me. Me as me defines me. People that are putting you down for just being you, as long as you're not hurting yourself and you're not hurting others. In my heart, it's not even like a gender expression or identity situation. It's like, someone's giving you hate for your sexuality, your weight, your race. Like, we all have our thing that people can give us hate for. If someone's giving you hate, they're not a happy person, but I digress. The reason I took down everything is because people were finding videos of me pre-transition, subscribing, thinking that was me currently, not watching recent videos, or like, bitches didn't get the memo. Coming on recent videos and commenting my dead name and just assuming that was me now. It's like, bitches didn't get the memo. So where does that leave us? I took down old videos and pictures. My ask to you guys is if you please do not spread old content or names or things from my past, and in return, I want to continue making LGBTQ plus content. I have so many ideas and things in the works. I don't know, I'm 22 years old and I learned more last year about myself and about the world and about empathy and about the others than I had my entire life. Things that I wish I could go back in time and like shake a baby Miles and be like, you're gonna be okay. From having a transgender experience, I've not only viewed the world in two different lenses, but I've been viewed as two completely separate different people. I did a series last year called Hella Gay. I traveled the country and talked to cool cats that are trans and queer and everything under the sun that are doing cool things, and that may be coming to YouTube, like my channel, soon. I'm just super passionate and super jazzed, and yeah, last year was amazing, and I love you guys. And I don't know, I feel like I should say this, not all my videos are gonna be queer and trans related. Like, that's one part of me. Like, a core part of me is like the passion I have and like working with kids and like doing cool things, but like there's also gonna be videos about other things because like, you know my channel, you're subscribed, hi.
Okay, but also, ow, I'm like too hype all the time to get surgery on my body.
So another video that was part of the takedown of videos was my original coming out video, So I'm Trans. The reason I privatized that was because I originally came out as transgender non-binary, which makes sense. My entire life I was told that you have to be this one thing, you have to do this one thing, and like everything else is bad. And when I originally came out, I was like so done with everything everyone had to say. I'm like, okay, just gender as a whole, no. I'm just gonna do me, but like thank you so much for the offer. From that experience of having the freedom for the first time in my life to really figure out unbiased opinion, like who am I, what do I wanna do, I found that I'm just a guy. Like, I'm not this great non-gendered being, I'm just Miles. So I identify as a guy, I'm a trans guy, and I felt weird having a coming out video online as something different to my label currently, so I took it down. I don't know, I have a weird job now where like I share things on the internet and then they stay there, and like that's, I was like, that's not, so I'm just gonna take it down. But all in all, I love you guys so much and like this video if like you're excited, cause like I love you daddies. The best way to keep in touch with me has been Snapchat. Okay, that's my video, I love you. Bye.